Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television for Monday, September 23rd, 2013. We're coming up to 9 a.m. on the East Coast, and both stock index futures and commodities are mixed this morning with a little bias to the downside, so not expecting a lot to happen at the open on Monday morning. This morning, I just wanted to do a quick recap of last week and just make sure everybody's on the same page. Last week was a Fed meeting, and so you've got 2 days where the Fed's meeting. On the Wednesday, it's Fed Day. That's the day that the minutes of the meeting are released. And not only are the minutes released, but now we've got an added bonus where the Fed chairman speaks. And so I don't, if you've been with us for any length of time, I don't trade on Fed Day. I don't even watch the market. I try to stay away from the computer as much as possible, so I'm not tempted to try to play the volatility that happens after the Fed minutes come out. There's a lot of people that really want to make their careers on being right around a Fed day, and it's a really bad bet because not only do you have to be right on what the Fed is going to say, but you also have to be right on how the market reacts to that news. And typically the reaction after a Fed meeting is wrong. And what happens is that the activity in the market after the Fed news comes out is people who are wrong in the market. And so those are the people that are most motivated to get out of their positions and cover their positions, whether they are long or short going into the Fed meeting. And so you often see the market thrust up or thrust down after the meeting, and that isn't really which way the market is going. That thrust, again, is driven by people who are wrong, who bet on the wrong side of not maybe what the Fed says, but how the market reacts to it. And so they quickly want to unwind their positions. And this year, what we saw was an extra reaction. We actually went into the next day moving higher. And so here we are up at the top of the panic zones. We had panic buying on Wednesday and Thursday. And on Thursday, we reversed and came down. And we're now back below what was resistance, 1718.75. We got above that on Wednesday. On Thursday, we ran out of buyers. On Friday, we came back down below it. Now, it is not a significant pullback so far. We have not taken out Wednesday's low yet, but looking at the moving averages, if Thursday was a top in the market, then a normal pullback would be back down to the 100-day moving average. You can see that's held us twice in the last 6 months, and we've got a nice uptrend line there that could also act as support. And so that would be a normal pullback down to the, let's say, 1650 level. And if that breaks, then a move down to the 200-day moving average, which is just coming up to 1600. That would also be considered normal and not a major breakdown in the market. So far, this top from Thursday is not locked in place yet. That would be locked in place if we close below Wednesday's low. And so on our daily chart, we're looking for a daily close below 1685.51 to give us a sell signal on Monday. Now, the Dow was a little more aggressive on the downside. You can see this is our pressure zone, bottom of the panic zone. That's the last low risk setup. Now we moved up to the top of the range, early warning signal. We're now seeing a pullback here. And we have now taken out last Wednesday's low on the Dow. And so we ran up to resistance at 15,625. Air got a little thin above it. We ran out of buyers, and here we come back down. So a more significant pullback in the Dow. Remember, only the public watches the Dow 30. The pros are watching the S&P 500. If we look at the Dow, though, you can see that the pros are starting to roll over here at a level in which the market has peaked in the past. So there's a high probability that last Thursday was the high. We need a daily close below 15,296 to give us a sell signal for the Dow. Now, what's holding the market up is the NASDAQ 100, and it peaked on Friday. Has not pulled back enough to be significant, and you see we need that close below last Wednesday's low. We're quite a bit away from that. And then for a daily sell signal, we need a close below 3169.46. to give us a sell signal on the NASDAQ 100. Now, the VIX for both the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ 100 are both still on sell signals, still below the lower channel line, so no major alarm bells there. One of the markets to totally reverse from the Fed meeting was the gold market. All the precious metals have reversed. They're back on sell signals. Most of the gold and silver stocks are also back on sell signals. For Barrick, we're looking for a close below 1830. We're back on a sell signal for Newmont. We're back on a sell signal for Pan American Silver. So unfortunately, this is one of the markets that overreacted to what happened at the Fed meeting and the chairman's comments. You can see the huge up move that we had on Wednesday, peaked on Thursday, and then started to roll over. And unfortunately, we're now back on a sell signal. Bonds also overreacted. We came into Wednesday's Fed meeting on a sell signal. Huge up move. The next day, of course, if you were taking these signals, you would have bought on the open. And here we are coming down. We got down to the lower channel line on Friday, closed in the middle of the channel. So we don't have a new sell signal yet for the bond market, but certainly a market that was spooked by the Fed meeting of last week. Next up, let's take a look at commodity prices. And we had no trend changes in the energy sector last week. There's Brent crude, there's West Texas crude, gasoline, heating oil still on sell signals. Natural gas still on a buy signal, but showing a little weakness, trading back in the channel on Friday. Copper had a big pop off the Fed meeting and held those gains on Thursday and Friday. Unfortunately, both gold and silver did not, and they are back on sell signals and trading lower in the pre-market on Monday. Last up this morning, quick look at the 60-minute charts, and it still will take a couple more days before the market gets back in sync. We still have the VIX on trading below the flypaper channel. As long as it stays below 1450, then we're not looking for a major breakdown in the market. We still have some room to go for the S&P 500. Down below 1683 would certainly be a concern. We have an early warning signal. We're still projecting lower prices here. Down to support at 1700, 1703, that wouldn't be a surprise on Monday. If we break that, then 1687.50 would be our next target to the downside. We're coming into Monday on an intraday sell signal. The first sign that that's changing on Monday is going to be an hourly close above 1719.29. Okay, folks, that's all for this morning's presentation. Just looking over my shoulder, the futures are still pretty stable, so we are looking for quiet open on Monday morning. Next time, we'll talk about the U.S. market as on Wednesday. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again soon.